Welcome to today's session, children. Hope you are fit and fine. Now, before moving to the current session of your chapter 5, that is Principles of Inheritance, now just identify this picture, children, what it is. Any guess? Yes, it's a chromosome. And today's session is about syndromes, where we will be dealing with conditions where a chromosome is added or decreased. What happens when this happens? And this condition where there is an increase or decrease of chromosomes to their total number, say for example 46 chromosomes are there in the human cell, what happens if it becomes 47, and what happens if it becomes 45? Here you are seeing two pictures, children. The first one is the karyotype of a human male, and the second one is a karyotype of a human female. What is a karyotype? The karyotype is the systematic arrangement of chromosomes from the longest to the shortest. And human karyotype is grouped into 7 groups: A, B, C, D, E, F, G. And this particular one is a karyotype of a normal male. And here you can see the 23rd one here. X and Y are shown. And what do you see, children? X and Y chromosomes are of a different size. What does that indicate? That means X and Y are not homologous chromosomes. They are not homologous to each other. So they don't carry same kind of alleles also. Okay. Now the next one is the human karyotype of a normal female. Here also you can see all the 22 pairs. And here the 23rd one, concentrate, children. You are seeing 2 X chromosomes, and both these X are of the same size, that is, they are homologous to each other. Okay. This I am showing you because you will now understand what happens if an extra 21st chromosome is added or an extra X chromosome is added by mistake, or by what are the reasons. We will see that in this current session. Okay. Chromosomal disorders. It is due to the absence or excess or abnormal arrangement of one or more chromosomes. Okay. And aneuploidy is a special case where there is a gain or loss of a particular chromosome. 2n plus 1. So 46 becomes 47 in case of 2n plus 1 condition, that is called trisomy. 46 chromosome number reduces to 45, that is 2n minus 1, that is called monosomy. Okay. Polyploidy is the case where 3n means what? 23 and one more 23, 46 plus 23 it is. 4n means what? 46 plus 46 it is. Okay, the total sets are increasing here, whereas aneuploidy means not the total set, only one chromosome is added or deleted. Okay. And how come that a chromosome is added or deleted? What is the reason? The reason is non-disjunction of chromosomes. Non-disjunction is the failure of homologous chromosomes or sister chromatids to separate properly during cell division. There are 3 forms of non-disjunction. Failure of a pair of homologous chromosomes to separate in meiosis 1. Recall meiosis 1, prophase 1 children and metaphase 1 children. Which you have learnt in class 11. That is very important here. So you know that homologous chromosomes pair during zygotene, and there is a crossing over happening during paquetine, isn't it? So recall all those. Homologous chromosomes pair, and after crossing over is done, after prophase 1, metaphase 1, they orient, and anaphase 1, they try to separate. So this separation is not happening properly. So in that case, both the chromosomes will go to one particular daughter cell. Then that particular daughter cell is receiving an extra chromosome, isn't it? So that's what. And failure of sister chromatids to separate during meiosis 2. Meiosis 2 is the same as mitosis, isn't it? So, mean meiosis 2 or mitosis also, sister chromatids fail to separate, then also one of the daughter cell will receive an extra chromatid, and the other daughter cell will not receive that particular chromatid at all. So, all these things can account for what is called as chromosomal disorders. These are the pictures of Henry Turner. And Henry Turner, Langdon Down, in fact, they have documented the occurrence of syndromes. And in the honor of Henry Turner, Turner syndrome has been named, and Down syndrome has been named in honor of Langdon Down. Okay, next you see Harry F. Klinefelter. Now, he is the first person who has documented certain abnormalities with gynecomastia. That means a male showing the female characters and hypogonadism, elevated follicle stimulating hormone levels, all these. So, in his honor, Klinefelter syndrome has been named. Okay. Down syndrome. It is due to the presence of an additional copy of the chromosome 21. So that is trisomy of the 21st chromosome. That means the individual who is suffering from Down syndrome is not having 21st chromosome 2. That is one maternal, one paternal, and one more extra. Three are there. Okay. So what are the symptoms here? The person is going to have a short statured, he is short statured with a small round head, furrowed tongue and partially open mouth. Palm is broad with physical characteristic palm crease. Physical, psychomotor and mental development is retarded. Okay, all these things. And the child could be a male or a female, because here it is a 21st chromosome. It is not an X chromosome here, isn't it? So in this case, XY होना चाहिए, that is 46 should have been, but 45 हो जाएगा because 21st chromosome 3 are there. So 45 plus XY in male, 45 plus XX in female, isn't it? Now what are the reasons for this we will look into? Yeah, a karyotype of the Down syndrome person is there. Here you see 21st chromosome 3 are there. Okay, so this is the karyotype of a Down syndrome person. Yeah, the same thing is shown in colors here for you to identify. Otherwise, the chromosomes are not naturally colored like this. Okay. So, you see how the Down syndrome palm, how it is. You are able to see that there is a reduction in the size of the palm, and how the fingers are, you see. By the normal one, you can see it is like this. So, make out the difference between normal and the abnormal one, isn't it? Now. See how the child is a Down syndrome child, and the mouth is kept open like this, not because the child wanted to do it. The child is probably unable to close it also. So it is this is one of the symptoms of a Down syndrome. Okay, now coming on to Klinefelter syndrome. Now it is caused by XXY genotype. So this genotype results in the from the union of a non-disjunct XX egg and a normal Y sperm, or probably a normal X egg with the abnormal XY sperm. The individual has 47 chromosomes, so this is also trisomy here, 2N plus 1 condition. Such an individual has overall masculine development. Now Y chromosome is there, so this person is a male. But because X chromosome also is there, XXY, two X chromosomes are there. So there is a male, but there is a feminine development, like development of breast and all. Okay, and such individuals are sterile, means the reproductive capacities are not there. Okay. So the reason for Klinefelter syndrome, you see, a normal ovum fertilized by an abnormal sperm, or an abnormal ovum fertilized by a normal sperm. Any one of these could be the reason for Klinefelter syndrome. So Klinefelter syndrome here, you can see the karyotype. The encircled one, two X chromosomes are there and a Y chromosome is there. Okay. Now next, moving on to what are the features of Klinefelter syndrome patient? You can see that there is a breast development here, but overall it is a male. Okay. Now coming on to Turner syndrome. It is caused by XO genotype. This genotype results from a union of an abnormal O egg with a normal X sperm, or a normal X egg and an abnormal O sperm. O means absence of the chromosome totally. So the individual has 45 chromosomes, that is 2N minus 1, that is called monosomic. Such a females. Now there is no Y chromosome here, X chromosome is also not there. But because the Y chromosome is not there, this particular individual is a female. But instead of 2X chromosomes, 1X is only there. So they are also sterile, and ovaries are rudimentary, means underdeveloped ovaries will be present and the uterus will be very small. And they are also sterile, means reproductive capacities will not be there. Yeah, so here I have shown one X chromosome and I have written here missing. That means it is not there. Okay, so this is called XO condition, 45 chromosomes. So this is case of a Turner's syndrome. Okay. So the person who is affected like this is a female, and you can see that not only that ovaries are rudimentary, uterus is small, but there is no menstruation also. Okay, and you can see that shield shaped thorax is there, poor breast development is there. So the secondary sexual characters also are underdeveloped in this particular female. Okay, in the next session we will be again meeting with interesting parts of human genetics, and until then, thank you, children.